support your Hobbit hobby.
Welcome, Strategy Battle Gamers, to another GBHL Battle Report. You are here with GBHL James, and today I'm joined by a special guest. We have got GBHL joint lead leader.
Joint with Ed.
We've got Thomas Harrison. Let's give him a round of applause. Woo! Okay, now I've travelled down south. I'm down south right now because I had to pick up a nice Kira Fungal kit, and Tom has kindly agreed to host me in lovely Bicester.
Don't know how lovely it is, but...
This is really nice. We've just been to the Wetherspoons, got ourselves some nice food, and we're in here...
James paid.
You don't have to lie to them. They like me anyway. And we're now in the conservatory amongst some very gorgeous-looking displays. And look at all those Hobbit trophies up there, guys. It's intimidating. I think they've been put onto some like pre-game mind game. And all of the models watching in the arena, which is going to be us doing our battle today. Now, Tom doesn't know, but this is a Get Buff Bat Rep. That's right. I hope you've got a press-ups. I'm all right at them, so I don't mind you beating me and me having to do press-ups on camera. Yeah, big victory so I can show off. I'm talking like, you know, beat me by 75 BB. I don't think we've got 75 BBs. Got a smallish army today, and just a little bit of a warning. Both of us are having some fun with armies that we would not normally play. So Tom has learned from Jamie, and he's decided not to get his tournament-winning Wood Elves out, because we all know that tournament-winning Wood Elves get smashed by all cavalry Rohan. What have you brought with you today?
So today I brought, instead of Wood Elves, all Galadrim Elves, but I brought the Galadrim Knights on the horse back. The issue with them usually is that they're just massive point sink, and I don't think compared to the Rivendell Knights that they're worth the points, but I wanted to try them out today.
Yeah, and he's doing this for camera. It's, you know, fun list. We're doing 450 point battle report today. And myself, I've actually come up with a nice theme to disguise the cheese, which I've kind of brought to the table for this battle report. Bringing some models that I've not ever used before, and borrowing some of Tom's. I saw the opportunity and I thought, you know what, we'll do that. So let's take a look at the armies. So we're going to start off with Tom's 450 point Galadrim force. What have you decided to bring and why?
So the leader is Haldir with an elven cloak and armour, and he's leading a bunch of Galadrim on foot, six with bows, three of those have spears as well, and then the rest are just a mix of spears and just hand weapons with shields, and then two Galadrim bowmen and horse at the back. Second warband is Rumil, okay, maybe a bit cheesy with his reroll six rule, and he's leading three Galadrim court, and then a bunch of elves, two of which have elven blades, just to help against any defense six or higher. And then three Galadrim knights, again, just with hand weapons and shields.
Absolutely fantastic. Now, a lot of our subscribers, Tom, have been asking us for a little bit of why people bring particular types of armies. Now, I know that we're having a bit of fun today, but what are the strengths and weaknesses of this kind of Galadrim force?
Well, I mean, I really like the Galadrim. I mean, Jamie loves the Wood Elves, but they are very low defense, so quite susceptible if you make a bad move or have some bad luck, whereas these guys with defense 5 and, well, okay, some defense 4 are a bit more durable if you do get into a spot of bother. And I just really love the Galadrim Knights. The guys on horse just really wanted to use them because I don't tend to bring them to tournaments, so that was the plan behind that.
Fantastic. And we're not playing tournaments today, which is why we're doing some fun and different forces.
Yeah.
Fun and different. Okay, so we're going to move on to my army. So this is the army that I'm going to be bringing today, something which I've never, ever, ever, ever done before. I don't even think I've ever played as an evil army. So the theme that we've gone for here is kind of a Kinstrife Umbar. So leading my force, it is the Dark Marshal, so a bit of cheese. And he's going to be representing Castamir, the usurper. Okay, nasty character. And he's going to be actually leading some of those Morgul Knights back there. They are Morgul Knights, however, we're going to call them Knights of Umbar for this. That's right, Knights of Umbar. See, I'm creating this theme so that people don't think I'm so cheesy. And we've also got over here, see these guys, that they look like orc spearmen, but what they are actually are salt thralls. So these are slaves which, you know, the Reavers have captured on their reavings out. And that's why I'm justifying bringing them along as cheap spear support. And then next up, we've got the next warband, which is led by the Corsair Captain. And behind, you can see, they look like Castellans of Dol Guldur. But they are actually Castellans of Umbar. So this is an upgrade to Black Numenoreans, which is cost 2 points and gives them fight 5, so the same as elves. And behind them are my wonderfully converted... What do you reckon?
Yeah, very good conversions.
They look alright?
Yeah.
They don't look too bad, do they? This is 6 of my Corsair Reavers. And just to point out as well, the hand weapon which they will be taking, because they can't take 2 different ones, it's going to be axes, which obviously makes sense with the piercing strikes.
Are we not allowed to take 2?
No, and not unless the
entry says.
Not unless the entry says. So, for example, like Hunter Orcs, the entry says yeah. Many blades will.
So you can't choose to faint as well as.
No, as much as I would love that, that would be great. But there's not going to be any fainting from those guys there. So that is my Kinstrife themed cheese army. Let's see how it gets on our battle. And this is going to be today's battleground. So this is how it looks after deployment. As you can see, I've kind of bunched myself up over there, completely different to what I would normally play, but should be interesting. I bunched up there, and in the meantime, Tom has kind of wheeled around on this flank here, so it kind of shortens the board. So we'll go straight into priority. Woohoo! Rolling for turn one, priority. And it's priority, evil.
So here how it looks after my movement. I've just moved up some of those Castellans of Umbar, supported them with the Thralls, the Salt Thralls with their spears. Moved up the Corsair Reavers up on that right flank. I moved up some of the Morgul Knights on the left flank. And what I'm going to do now is I'm moving, this is all pre-measured, so I'm moving the Dark Marshal up to here. And he's going to be casting Sap Will on Rumil, who is 12 inches away. So are you going to resist?
Well, you
I've got to roll anyway, haven't I? See, I'm being taught magic here. He's teaching me, he's going to teach me some good things here. Okay, so I need a 3 plus. Oh, and we get a 5.
And Rumil only has 1 will, so even if he did resist, it's gone anyway. So
Rumil is now unwilling. So the elves have now moved. What Tom's decided to do is he's moved some of his Galadrim knights up there a little bit further out to the left flank, just so they get some shots on the Defence 4 Reavers, so don't blame them. And he's moved these guys just swinging around against my line slightly. So we're going to go into shooting. So Evil has no shooting, so we're going to go straight to the Galadrim shooting. And I think there are 5 bowmen.
Six
bowmen
plus
Haldir with his 2. And they're going to be shooting into, and rightly so, the Salt Thralls. You like that every time, don't you? The Salt Thralls that are supporting the Castellans of Umbar. So these guys didn't move. They need 3 plus. In the ways for the Castellans. 3 hit the Castellans, needing 6s. Oh, nothing. And 2, including Haldir, hit the Salt Thralls.
Nothing.
And nothing. So, unsuccessful round of shooting. So, the 2 Galadrim Knights here, as you can see, they can see some of the Corsair Reavers. They're going to be firing that guy in the middle, knowing the ways. They move, so needing 4s. 1 hit. And needing 5s to kill. Oh. Oh. And it's a 4. Sad face. So nothing with the shooting there, and there's no combat, so we're going to go on to turn 2, priority. And it's priority evil. And this is how it looks at the end of turn 2.
Movement.
And so you can see my lines moved up a little bit there. The Dark Marshal, Castamir, has moved up, but he's chosen not to do anything with his will at this point. The Morgul Knights are keeping hold of that left flank. So stuck one out there, maybe is tempting, but Tom is just a clever boy. No chance, he wasn't biting it. And all he's moved so far, I think, is just the cavalry. Make sure those guys are out of range and just move these guys for some bow shots. So we are going to move into Tom's shooting. So these 6 bows here and Haldir's 2 shots are going to be shooting through the Castellans again at the Orc Spearmen. We haven't moved this time, so 3s to hit. In the ways for the Castellans of Umbar. 2 get through. So needing 6s to kill the Castellans. Oh, and one of them goes down. So Haldir has killed a Castellan. What can the elves do? Needing 5s. And nothing. So next up, you've got the 2 Galadrim Knights who've moved. They're going to be firing at the Reavers again. Needing 4s to hit. 2 misses. Oh, we're on to turn 3, priority.
And I didn't want a priority that time, actually. So it's priority evil.
So in what looks like a Dawn game, I'm coming towards the end of my movement. Although, just coming in here because Castamere, the Dark Marshal, has moved forward half of his movement, so it negates the Elven Cloak of Haldir, and he's going to cast his Sap Will. Are you going to resist it? You don't resist it. I'm learning all the time. And he gets a 3. And that's it, yeah?
Yeah.
And it's a 3+, so his will is gone. And I will finish his movement. I moved him back.
Out of the way.
So this is how it's looking towards the end of both of our movements. You can see that I've kind of come around on that right flank. Didn't really want to get priority. So I didn't really want to get countercharged by coming in too close. Just wheeled round there. He's wheeled round as well. Quite a nice bold move into my left flank where the knights are around the ruins. I did go forward before and I casted Sap Will, which was successful on Haldir. And over here we're about to roll to see if these three can get in on the bait, which was the Morgul Knight on that left flank. So we're going to roll each of them for courage. Unbelievable. First one fails. Are you sure you want to continue with these two? Yeah. Fail! He gets in, one gets in. Next one, and they both get in. So we get two in there, just as you said.
Yeah.
Just as you said. So this is how it looks at the end of that movement. So we're going to go into shooting. Now, Haldir's bow elves over there, they're going to actually start off shooting at the reavers that are exposed here, maybe getting a nice shot at the Dark Marshal. Castamere. So the elves are shooting.
Oh, that's good.
So I should kill them, needing 2 5s. And we get 2 6s. So 2 reavers go down. So now the path is clear for Haldir to take a shot at the Dark Marshal, needing 3+. He gets 1. What does he hit? Horse or rider? Hits the rider, which he doesn't really want. Needing 6s. 6s and 4s, because defense 8, yeah?
Yeah.
So 6s followed by 4s. Oh! And he doesn't do anything. I'm guessing you wanted the horse at that
moment. Yeah, the horse would have been better.
Horse would have been better. And that's... Oh, no, you've got some more shooting.
Yes.
So these guys are going to shoot at...
The Reavers with Orc Spearmen in the way.
Yeah, so the Reavers with Orc Spearmen in the way. So one hits. Does it hit the Orc? It does hit the Orc. 5 to kill the Orc. And it's a 4, and they don't kill him. So after that round of shooting, pretty successful, 2 reavers dead, that's quite good going. We're going to go into the only combat, which is the 2 Galadrim Knights versus the Morgul Knight. So we just checked the Morgul Knight, he does have a sword hung down by his side, so he's going to faint, and one of the Galadrim is also going to faint. So rolling to 6, obviously if you get a 6.
Fainting is
the red one. So you get a 5 highest. So come on, 6! Oh! No way! No way! And he beats them back, no way. So we're blaming that guy in the background for not bringing his attacks to bear. So we're gonna obviously strike the man, and we need 5s to kill. Oh no! And one of them goes down. Wow. That was unexpected. So that is the end of turn 3. So moving on to turn 4 priority, this will be where I don't get priority, when I possibly want it. So here we go. Oh! And we do get priority. So as kind of expected, I think, Rumil is calling a heroic move, which is going to be countered by the Dark Marshal. Now, it was my priority, so Jamie, that means that I have to roll. Jamie, I roll now. 1 to 3. I'll get punished now for taking the mickey out of him. Oh, and it goes to the good.
Okay, so Rumil's going to charge a Morgul Knight. Now, the issue is he has to take a courage test, and if he fails this, he won't be moved as part of the heroic move, and therefore people can't go with him. So he really needs to pass this courage test.
Double ones. Talked it up. No, easy. Easy. So that's the end of Tom's heroic move. You can see a bit of a heroic sacrifice going on there. A couple of guys failed their courage test, but on the whole, he got in what he wanted to get in. So we're going to go into my normal movement. So here's how it looks at the end of movement. So you can see
I brought some Morgul Knights round. His guy was in the back, passed his courage test, so he separated out that combat. The heroic sacrifice guy has kind of been mobbed a little bit there. Managed to get a couple of my guys into combat with some of the supports, and then a few more just in reserve. And lots of action over here. The Castellans of Umbar moved up, and their Salt Thralls came up behind to support, who have been in turn charged by the Galadrim Knights. So, that's how the battlefield looks. Let's move into shooting. So the only shooting is going to go to Haldir, who is shooting through his own guy there, because he's in base contact. He's going for the Corsair Reaver. So he gets two shots.
Forced
to hit, yeah, because he's moved. And both hit, which is what he wants. So, do you want to do one at a time? Do five. One at a time. Not
fast. So,
five to kill. Nope, and again. Yay! So another Reaver goes down.
Take him away.
So Haldir's doing pretty well. He's killed two now. So we're going to go into combats, and pretty inevitably, I've gone in for a heroic combat with the Dark Marshal, which makes him mightless, I believe.
Yes.
So we'll do that combat first. So the elf is shielding, and what am I doing? I'm going to piercing strike with the Corsair Reaver, and I'm going to. Can you feint if you're using your lance?
No, just, lance.
Just use the lance. So yeah, we'll go with that. So the big dice are is the Morgul Knight, and the blue dice is the Reaver. What happens? Oh, and we get six. So we take that combat. So the Galadrim has been knocked down. So let's see what strength the Reaver goes up to. And he goes up by a one, so he's now strength four. So four's on the big orange dice because of the lance, and fives and everything else. Yeah. Very, very dead. So the Galadrim goes down, and I'll continue my heroic combat. So after successful heroic combat, well and truly dead Galadrim, the Reaver has moved round to attack this guard of the Galadrim court. Fight six, those guys, yeah. Very handy. So he's gone away into that combat. Now I did muse with bringing the Dark Marshal in against these guys, but I thought we'll use his banner rerolls probably a little bit more, especially as the force leader, and keep him a bit protected. And then the Morgul Knight over there has charged in on a spear supporting elf. So we'll go into the rest of the combats. So we're going to start off with some of the easier combats. We're going to go for the Morgul Knight versus the Galadrim. I did charge here, so I do get the lance bonus. So let's see, do you get the six that you need? Gets a five. Get a six. Oh, we get a four. So the Galadrim wins that fight. So you're striking the.
For the man, sixes to kill.
Right? Striking a man, needing sixes to kill. Oh, and he gets a three. Next up is the Morgul Knight, who doesn't have his lance bonus against the Galadrim. Let's see what they get. Oh, and the Morgul Knight gets this one.
I know, it's an obvious call.
I didn't call to faint. It's my own mistake, so as nice as Tom is, I'm not taking it. So I'm going for the guy, and I need fives. We get a two, and he lives. Next up, we've got the guard of the Galadrim court there, who would be trapped if he dies, against the Castellan of Umbar and the supporting orc. So the Castellan is going to faint. Going for it.
Going for it.
Let's see what he gets. He gets five highest. Get two attacks, Galadrim.
I know this guy.
Oh, yes, sir. Okay, and... Oh, yes, that's exactly what we wanted.
Of course.
So
you get double strikes.
So we get double strikes on that one there. So I need fives off these four dice, rerolling ones on the orange dice. And one was enough. So next up, we've got the Corsair Reaver, and he's going to be fighting against the two guys there. And he is... What the hell, he'll piercing strike.
Yeah,
why not? I wouldn't normally, but... Since it's nearly 6 o'clock already, you know. Alright, let's go. Oh, yes! Oh, Reaver! I'm so glad I converted you. Let's see what strength he goes up to. What strength do we go up to? So, yeah, I've gone up to strength 6, so I need a 4. So I need a 4 to kill him. Oh, yes, and he goes down.
Good job you did the piercing strike.
It is a good job I did the piercing strike. It was a gamble, but so what the hell. So this is where Rumil makes it up for some of his pals. I'm going to faint with the Morgul Knight, And I've only got single, so let's see what you get. And you get a six, so I can't beat you with that. So, I move back. And you're going to be striking the man?
Yep, on fives.
On fives to kill him. Whee! And he's very dead. So, the Morgul Knight guys. Oh, bye-bye. Next up, we'll do the Morgul Knight who charged that Galadrim on his own. Tom's going for it. He's not shielding. Let's see what we get. Oh, missed the turret completely. And you win that fight. So, he's going for the armoured horse, so he needs fives. Where's your dice? Oh, and he gets a four. So, Morgul Knight is okay. So next up we've got the Corsair Reba, who is piercing striking against a fainting Galadrim supported by a spearman. So let's see what you get. Oh, and he gets a five and I get a four. So what defense does the Reba go down to? Ouch! Goes down to defense one.
Threes.
So threes, off two dice.
Ones on the rat.
Let's see if you can get it. Double ones!
No!
Whoa! No! No! No way! No way! You can't even roll that. Reroll that. That is unbelievable. Whew! Give me a reaction.
No, I don't want
to. You picked up Jamie's camera curse.
Oh, man.
Oh, dear.
I'm just going to say that we just keep rolling and keep rolling until we get a really bad roll for James wins. That's how
this is the tic-tac. It's to build up my popularity on the channel. So we'll go to the next combat. Unbelievable.
That was amazing.
So next up we're doing a Castellan of Dol Guldur, his Salt Thrall supporting versus the single Galadrim on his own. Any special strikes?
No, he can't. So he's just trapped in there without a friend.
Let's see what happens. It's a one. And I get a three high. So I do win that fight. So I need fives to kill. And the Salt Thrall kills him. So Tom has casted Blinding Light to light up the battlefield. The moon has come out. The moon has come out in this battle. So we'll continue into the next combat. So next up, I'm going to do the Salt Thrall, the Orc Warrior, versus the charging Galadrim Knight. So let's see what you get. Oh! These Salt Thralls are awesome. They should be made into a real unit. So you are pushed back. So, be very unlikely. Fives to kill the guy. Oh! No way! What is going on? This rolling. Well, I think Tom is learning that my actual secret to winning is a cheating dice roll. Although I am using your dice.
Yeah.
So
using them better than I am.
Wow. Okay, so we're going to go on to the next combat. Unbelievable. So next up, let's see if the next Salt Thrall can survive against the Galadrim Knight. What does the Galadrim Knight get? Six. And I can't win that even with the banner reroll. So, five. He's knocked down. You need fives to kill him. And just. It's deserved, to be fair. He needs to swing back. He needs to swing back with your way at some point. And on to the next combat. So next up, we're going to do the Castellan of Umbar on the end against the two Galadrim.
I'm going to two-hand with the one in red.
Two.
I know, I've not paid for it. I can't two-hand for it. I'm going to faint.
You're going to faint. You're going to faint. Fantastic. Okay, and I am going to shield. You get four highest, and you take it with a six. So the Castellan gets knocked back. So needing sixes, fainting on the red dice. Hey! And he kills one. Good work. Next up, it's the 2-on-2, the Salt Thrall and the Castellan of Umbar versus the Galadrim. Let's see what happens. He gets a six. Do I get a six? No! 2-on-1. So we are beaten back. Okay, sixes to kill. Ooh, I saw a six for a second. Nah. Bounced off. Nah. So very lucky there. Next up, it's the Castellan of Umbar and the... I do laugh every time I say it. The Salt Thrall, the Orc Warrior, against the two Galadrim there. Let's see what happens. And he takes it. And he takes it. So we are knocked back. So they need sixes to kill.
Adds up.
But unfortunately, he doesn't die. Next up, charging Morgul Knight with his lance.
In the shield.
And he lives.
keep forgetting to do my re-rolls
with the banner.
With the banner. Never mind. So, that takes us to the end of a pretty brutal... pretty brutal round of combat. These are the casualties. I'm going to go into turn 5. Okay, so priority. This is the one that you're going to win when... I want to win this one. Come on. He gets a 3. Come on, give me... No! No! The Eye of Sauron. No! So you get priority. So having lost that priority, I have called a heroic move with the captain, which is being countered with Haldir. So I've only got 1 point of might remaining on the board. You've got 4 in total. So it was your priority. So 1, 2, 3. It's me. 4, 5, 6. It's you.
Been doing well at rolling low.
No! And the elves get it. So Haldir charged in with his heroic move there, and Thomas decided it's risky, but he's going to try and do his courage test to stop the spells of the Dark Marshal. It's -1. Come on. Looks good. No, it's not good.
-1.
It's -1. So he fails. Oh. Ugh.
And he doesn't get it.
Shame. So Haldir's heroic move cancelled out my own as he's managed to charge the captain. And he's just been doing the rest of his normal movement here. He's going to try and charge in on the Dark Marshal. Let's see what he gets. Oh, and he makes it. This is a heroic sacrifice?
Yeah.
So he's in there. Oh, this is how it looks. We've got the Galadrim here who charged in on the Morgul Knight. The other Galadrim failed to charge the Morgul Knight because... Again, because of Harbinger of Evil, which freed up the Morgul Knight to come round here into this combat, which is going to split interestingly. We've got these two guys on that Galadrim. The Morgul Knight managed to charge the guard of the Galadrim court. Then we've got Rumil over here, who is fighting against just the Castellan on his own, and an Orc warrior, a Sol Thrall, against a Galadrim on his own there as well. And then over here, we've got a Corsair Reaver and the Salt Thrall against the Galadrim. We've got another combat which is set up nicely here. These guys over here, this is pretty much how it's looking. We're going to go straight into combats. So Tom is calling a heroic combat with Rumil there against the Castellan of Umbar, who would be trapped. And he's also calling one with Haldir over here against the Castellan, who will also be trapped if he loses the combat. So which one are you doing first?
We'll do Haldir first.
So Haldir is going to two-handed with the red dice. So let's see what he gets. Oh, got a 4 highest. So my shielding Castellan. Yeah! What a hero. He's my hero. That was lucky. I think is the word.
It was a 3 highest with the 2-handed.
Unbelievable. So where there's a yin, there's always a yang. Let's see what happens here. Rumil is two-handed as well, and I'm going to shield.
I know he doesn't have to use trapped.
I am trapped. Here we go. Oh, no way. Yeah, but watch me get a 2 highest here. Oh, dear. That is so unlucky.
It's gone well.
This is just not, it's not fair. It's not fair. Ouch. So the 2 heroic combats, that is highly unlikely. So here we go, we've got the Morgul Knight versus the Galadrim, who charged him.
You're fainting.
And I will be fainting. Oh, he's got a 4. Come on. And it's a 3. So a little bit of justice there. So you need 6s. Are you going to go for the horse?
Kill the horse.
So he's going to go for the horse. Oh, and the horse survives. So the Galadrim, what's he called? Guard of Galadrim Court. He's going to shield against the Morgul Knight here, who has charged in, so he's using his lance, so he can't faint. Let's see if you get that 6.
Shielding.
And you get that 6, so I cannot win that fight. So next up, we've got the shielding Galadrim there against the piercing strike of the Corsair Reaver and the lance charge of the Morgul Knight. So let's see what you get. You get a 6, so I can only draw this. And it is drawn. Now it's your priority.
So let's see if I win a roll off. I don't tend to do well in roll offs, so I did get quite a few last time. Let's see what happens. Oh, and it goes to good off a rebound. So you push me back. Next up, we've got the Salt Thrall versus the Galadrim Warrior. So I've not got any sword or anything, so I can't faint. So let's see what you get. Three highest. Four! Oh my days. These Salt Thralls have been superstars. Okay, mind you, that's Commentator's Curse now. I roll a one to kill. Okay, so I need a five. And it's a four. So next up, we've got the two Galadrim there against the Corsair Reaver. The Corsair Reaver is not going to piercing strike on this occasion.
One elf will faint.
And one elf will faint. So let's see what we get. Four highest. And we get a four. So it's drawn, it's your priority. So do I win a roll off? Where's it? It's on the floor.
Can't have that one.
It was a two as well. Oh, we take one. So I didn't piercing strike on that occasion, so needing fives. And he didn't need to. So the Galadrim is not going to shield, he's just going to go for it. And we've got two piercing strikes of the Corsair Reavers. So this is where you get your six. Let's see what happens. He gets a five. So...
He was in the last fight.
Oh, was he in the last fight? Sorry about that. Okay, so we've got the two from the piercing strike of the Corsair Reaver and the one from the Salt Thrall. Oh, and he takes it.
What's his defense?
So what does he go down to? Ooh, he's gone down to two. You need threes.
Yeah.
So let's see if you kill him. You should do. Yay! And another Reaver goes
down.
That was well worth the strike. Next up, we've got the Dark Marshal against the single Galadrim there. It's one-on-one.
Because you charged me. Oh no, you're fight six, you get
fight six. Fight six, yep. Yeah. So, let's see which dice gets the highest.
Oh,
thank goodness for that. So you are pushed back, and I need fives. Oh, what? What's going on with these sixes? I'm a lucky boy tonight. So next up, we're doing the Galadrim, who did charge the Morgul Knight. The Morgul Knight is going to faint, and he is supported by a Salt Thrall, our favourite unit of the game. So let's see what happens. Oh, he gets a two. And Salt Thrall gets another six. These bad boys, I'm converting myself some of these. Seriously, I'm just going to get a bunch of spear orcs. I'm just going to paint them like humans and call them Salt Thralls. Okay, let's see what happens. Not needing fives, re-rolling the ones on the big orange dice. And the Salt Thrall. Oh my gosh. Everybody, my best piece of advice is get yourself some salt. What do you reckon?
No.
Get yourself some Salt Thralls. So next up, it's the Captain and the Salt Thrall versus the Galadrim Warrior. So the Captain, and you are fainting?
No, I've got a friend behind.
Oh, you've got a friend behind, yeah, sorry. Okay, so let's see what happens. You get a six. And we also get a six. Now, we both fight five. So it's a roll-off. Oh, no. Oh, no. So I've been really good in the combats and the wounding, but not in the roll-offs. So let's see what happens here. Oh, I win one. Oh, my days. Thank goodness for that. So we need fives off these. Let's have a look. Oh, and the Salt Thrall. I know that the captain did it as well, but I'm giving it to the Salt Thrall because these are the stars of the show. Next up is the Castellan of Umbar, supported by a Salt Thrall versus two Galadrim. Let's see what happens.
It's a double one.
Double one, and double twos take it. Unbelievable. So, needing fives to kill.
Ooh.
Next up it's the Galadrim and the Castellan of Umbar versus... What? It's the Galadrim and the Castellan of Umbar versus the Salt Thrall? Salt Thrall could take them both on. It's the Salt Thrall and the Castellan of Umbar versus the Galadrim. Let's see what happens. It's the three highest. And we get a three. So
banner.
It is draw. Sorry?
Banner.
Oh, banner reroll. Thank you for reminding me because I've not been doing these. Oh, thank you so much, Mr. Harrison. Why couldn't you remind me on the last few combats? Yes. Okay, so needing fives. So this is how it looks at the end of this turn. So we're going to go into next turn priority. And it's pretty key, isn't it? Pretty important. Ooh. So it's turn 6 priority. Come on, evil! Oh, no!
Yo, yes!
That was important. That was important. So Rumil is using his last point of might to call a heroic move. And this is probably to try and get something to combat with the Dark Marshal to stop him from casting. So let's see what happens. So here's how it looks after movement. Rumil did what I thought he would do with his heroic move, which was to arrange things so that he could get the charge on the Dark Marshal. And then I pretty much moved everything in over here, getting ourselves into different little combats, lots of little charges around here. And on Tom's normal movement, he did bring a Galadrim Knight around there to charge a Corsair. So there's no shooting. So on to combats. So we're going to start off with the easy ones. We've got the Morgul Knight who is feinting against the Galadrim. Let's see what happens. Galadrim gets a 5, so we need a 6. Oh, no way! No way! How many times has that happened?
I don't know why you're saying no way.
I'm definitely cheating. I'm definitely cheating. Wow. So he gets pushed back. So because I stupidly fainted, which means obviously I can't use the lance, which would have been 4s, it is going to be 5s, re-rolling 1s. And it didn't hurt anyway, which is lucky. So next up, the Morgul Knight, who got charged. He did get charged.
Yes.
So I'm going to be fainting there and piercing strike him with the Corsair Reaver against a shielding Galadrim. So let's see what happens. You get a 6. And we get a 6 as well. So it's the roll off. It's my priority. Is this the first time I rolled a roll off in this game?
Maybe first or second, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Okay, so we want a 1-3. No! And Tom wins another roll off. No way! So next up, the guard of the Galadrim Court against the fainting Morgul Knight who got charged. Let's see what happens. Oh, I got a 1. So the knight gets pushed back. And you need 6s. Well, you get a 1. So next up we're doing Rumil versus the Castellan of Umbar. Let's see what Rumil gets first, because if he gets 6, I can't win. And he gets a 6. So I'm pushed back. And you need 5s. Let's kill him. Hey, double 5. And the Castellan goes down.
Yeah, we should save that for another time.
So next up, the Orc Warrior with Spear, the Salt Thrall.
Yes.
He's going to be taking on the Galadrim. Galadrim fighting normal?
Yes.
He gets a 4. Can we get more? Oh! Another one! Oh my days! I'm telling you, these Salt Thralls for winners. There's 5s to kill, no way. Can't be another one. No way, no way, no way. Oh, no way! No way! Oh my days! I don't even think we need to do the men of the match in the post-battle battle rep breakdown. This has been so unlikely. Wow. Who'd have thought it? Orc warriors with spears.
7 of them, and they've caused carnage.
They've taken down most
of them. Yeah, I think so.
They are the ones. Wow, who needs reavers? Tom's been cheating during the game.
I brought it up for you.
You did indeed. And we've just realised that the Black Numenoreans upgraded to the Castellans of Umbar are also terrifying. So we do need to be rolling terror tests to charge it.
Yeah, and pass them all.
Next up, we're going to do a piercing, striking Corsair Reaver versus the Galadrim Knight. So let's see what happens.
Charging Knight.
You were charging, so you get 2 dice. He gets a 5. And we get a 4, so he wins that. So we go down by defense. We go down by 2 to defense 2, so you're going to kill me on 3s. Have you got a lance?
No.
No, okay, so. Kill me on 3, should get me. Yeah, and that Reaver is very dead.
He should have been dead earlier.
I wish I hadn't brought him, to be honest. I should have just brought more thralls. More of these thralls would have been good. Okay, on to the next combat. Yeah, I think you should shield against it. Okay, so we've got the Galadrim versus the Salt Thrall. And Tommy's contemplating shielding because of the terror of a Salt Thrall. Okay, so let's see what happens here. Oh, he gets a 5. Can I get a 6? Oh, no way! No way! No way! There's just no way! How is this happening?
You don't know how many dice rolls we've done to plan that one.
Do you know what? This is just unbelievable. Wow. Unbelievable. So, he needs fives to kill. It's almost like a competition between them to see who can kill the most Galadrim. See what happens? Oh, no, no. He doesn't manage it. Ooh, you're rubbish. So, again, we've been forgetting the rerolls. We've gotten a few things during this, but we're having a good time, aren't we?
Yeah.
We're having a great time. So, we've got the Galadrim on foot versus the Dark Marshal.
Who needs rerolls when you've got the Salt Claws?
Yeah, who needs rerolls when you've got Salt Claws rolling sixes all the time? Okay, so let's see who wins this one. Oh, he gets the six. So I need a six, and no, we get a one, so we actually lose that combat. So the Galadrim is going for the horse, needing fives. Let's see what happens. No, and it's a one. Woof! It's a close one. Tell me, cheat, moving my banner further back. Okay, next up we've got the Castellan of Umbar and the Salt Thrall versus the Galadrim Knight. So, so we take it. So we need fives to kill him.
Survive.
Oh, and he goes down. Salt Thrall, what are you doing? It's usually you. Come on. Well, so it's the Galadrim versus the Salt Thrall. Let's see what happens. You get a three. Oh, and it's about time when they've lost the combat. So he moves back an inch.
Banner.
Oh, got a banner reroll. Oh, well remembered. Way! Tom, well remembered. I don't think I'd remembered a single banner reroll in this game.
As long as it's 6 inches banner, I think it is, isn't it?
Yeah, it is indeed. Right, so, do we get the five to kill him? No, we get a one. So he's backed up. Next up, the Castellan of Umbar and his Salt Thrall versus two Galadrim there. Let's see who wins this one. Five highest. Oh, and the Salt Thrall wins it. For them! So, we need fives to kill them. Oh, and we don't kill either. Okay, it's Haldir and Friend versus the Castellan. I'm gonna go normal.
Okay, just go for I'll it. Think with... Oh no, I can't, because Haldir loses.
Yeah, fine. Give me a six. No. So, the Castellan is pushed back. So, Tom has taken up the role as official banner rememberer. So, can we get a six on the second dice? No. So, sixes with the green dice, fives with the red dice. Nothing. Ouch. So, we need to kill two more to break Tom. We've got the Corsair Captain and his Salt Thrall versus the elf on his own. You get a four. And we get that six. So, the Captain is going to need... both of them need fives, I think.
Yeah.
Both of them need fives here against the elf.
Fours for the Captain.
Fours.
Defense four without a shield.
Oh, he's defense four without a shield, yeah, because he's got a bow. Okay, so fours from the orange dice, fives from the blue dice. Oof. Look at that Salt Thrall rolling at six. What a legend. So with the last combat of the turn, this is actually quite important. The Morgul Knight who charged the Galadrim on foot, if I kill him, you are broken going into next turn. So, let's see what happens. What are you going to roll? Don't roll a six, roll a one. A four. Oh, oh.
Tempting.
Oh, I've got a 50-50 chance. Oh! And we get the five, so he's knocked down. So we're gonna get double dice. And we did have a lance there. We got, yep, so we got four dice. We need fours. Here we go. Oh, lucky. Lucky one. Takes him down. It's only broken. But you are elves.
Mm-hmm.
You are elves, so high courage. Mind you, Harbinger of Evil. Let's see what happens.
Yeah.
So, let's go on to a priority that I wouldn't mind you winning. So, Tom needs to kill four more to break me, so I want to avoid getting four killed. We're on to priority, quite important again. Let's see what happens. And it's priority to evil. So, Haldir has called a heroic move, which has been countered by the Captain. So the last points of might on the table are gone. My priority, Jamie, can you hear this? My priority, Jamie, which means that I roll. Okay, and on a 1-3, I've got to get another one, maybe. No, with the drama of this game, it's not going to happen. What have I done? I've cursed myself. No. Oh,
and we get priority.
So this is how it's looking at the end of my heroic move and movement, because my captain has charged in on Haldir, and these guys therefore are all able to move in, tie up their various foes. Pretty much moved everything that I want to move now, except for the Dark Marshal, who's going to be moving up and casting Transfix.
He's got 6 will remaining.
On Haldir. He's got 6 will remaining. Ooh. So it's 3 plus to cast, and obviously we set the will of Haldir before. I do have 6 will remaining, and we don't think the game will probably last another 3 turns. So because of the situation, I'm going to use 3 of his will. Casting on a 3 plus. Watch this now. Triple ones. Oh! And it is cast. So Haldir is transfixed. So the one Galadrim needing to roll his courage. Will he stay? Will he go? He's out of range.
So he just needs a 5?
Just needs a 5. And he makes it. So Galadrim now has to take another courage test. A terror test. Let's see whether he can get through. Second one. Oh, and he makes it. So he's into combat. We're going to go into the combat phase. So first up, we're going to go with the Salt Thrall versus the Galadrim. So let's see what happens here. And it's drawn, which means the Galadrim... Oh, I've got a banner reroll. Thank you for reminding me. Oh, it doesn't make a difference on this instance. So you need a 5 to kill him.
Didn't really do with this.
Oh, no way. Because that is one, really, you should be killing. Next up, the Chargian Morgul Knight, who loses attack because he has been countercharged by the Galadrim, but he does keep his lance bonus, and he's up against those two guys. So...
The Galadrim on the horse will faint.
Galadrim on the horse is fainting. It's 4 highest. And we get a 2, so he does win that one. However, I get a banner reroll, as pointed out. Hey! Thanks, Tom. So I'm going to put my attack on the guard of the Galadrim court because he's fight 6. So I need 4s. Oh, and we get a 2. So he lives. Next up, the Morgul Knight who charged the Galadrim on foot. Any special shielding or anything? Nope. So I'm using the lights. And you get a 3. Can we beat it? And we beat it. So needing 4s to kill him with the lance. And he dies. So the most epic combat of the game surely has got to be Rumil versus a Salt Thrall. So let's see what happens. Okay, you roll yours first. Yeah, you get a 6, so I can't beat you. Shall I roll anyway? Should we just see what he would have got? He got a 1, but he gets a banner reroll. And he gets another 1. This one's destined to die.
He lost anyway.
Yeah, he lost anyway.
And
4s. And 4s to kill. Oh, no way! No way. Just the dice gods, I don't think, have been with you. Apart from on roll-offs.
Yeah, on roll-offs.
Yeah, but really, you didn't need all those roll-offs, really. So the piercing, striking Reaver charged in on the Galadrim Knight. Let's see what we both get. You get a 4, and I get a 5. The Corsair goes up to strength. Goes up by 1 to strength 4, so it's still 5s. 5s. Oh, and he doesn't kill him. 2 4s. Next up, we've got a shielding Galadrim against the charging Morgul Knight and the Spear Thrall. The Spear Thrall? The Soul Thrall. Soul Thrall. Getting the names wrong now. Oh, that can't be good. So you shielded, you get 5 highest. Oh, yes, and we get that 6. So, 5s from the Thrall and 4s from the Morgul Knight. Yeah. Very dead. So next up, we've got the Castellan of Umbar and the Salt Thrall versus the Galadrim. Galadrim doing anything?
Just fighting.
He's just going to fight as normal. You get a 4. And we get a 5 with that Spear Thrall. Salt Thrall. Why do we call them Spear Thralls? So needing 5s on both. Oh! And we don't get it. And he lives. Next up, the Castellan of Umbar and his Salt Thrall against the 2 Galadrim there. Let's see what happens. 4 highest, and we get a 5, and we win that combat. So, needing 5s to kill. Oh, both die! Ouch. Ouch. Oh dear, and this is how the dead piles are looking. So, one-on-one, the Castellan versus the Elf. Let's see what happens. Get a 4,
and we get that 5. So we need 5s to kill. And it's a 1. And next up is the Haldir fight. We've got the Corsair Captain against the Transfixed Haldir. What happens when you transfix a model?
You halve your fight value and number of fights. So you've now got a higher fight value, and I only roll 1 dice with Haldir.
Let's see what happens. So the orange dice is the Captain, the red dice is the Charging Morgul Knight, and the blue dice is the Salt Thrall. And of course the Salt Thrall got a 6. Of course he did, because they are amazing. So he is knocked down. So we need 5s with the blue dice and the orange dice, and the kind of red C3 dice need 4s because of the lance. So let's see if we kill him. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Haldir goes down. Your force leader goes down, which is 3. And I get a might back because of Contest of Champions. So the Corsair Captain wins himself some might. So Tom is going to roll for it to end. On a 1 or a 2, the game ends. You rolling?
Yeah.
Oh, pressure. Let's see what happens.
Put myself out of my misery.
Well, you know, that was a bad swing. Yeah, that was a bad swing. Bad round for you. There's been a couple of rounds like that. Okay, let's see. And it's a 4, the game continues. So to give you an idea of how important that turn was, at the start of the turn it was something like 12 models.
Well, that just before the end of the turn, yeah. Before it was 12 to 10.
It was 12 to 10. In that turn, I managed to kill 7, including Haldir, without return. So quite a good round for me. So we're going into priority. And it's priority to me. So the Dark Marshal is going to charge in on Rumil. And he's going to just use one of his will to try and cast Transfix. So let's see if he gets it. And on 4, he doesn't get it. Is it a 5 plus?
No, he's got it.
Oh, he's got it. Fantastic. He did get it. That's a good thing. Woo! So, yeah, he got it. So this is how it looks at the end of my movement. And I've pretty much got everything into contact there. Obviously, the Dark Marshal charged Rumil. Some of my knights charged around here. Just a spear thrall there. The main effort really was to try and completely and utterly destroy this Galadrim with a heroic combat from the point of mine that got back. Got these guys over here and these guys over here, so I am calling the heroic combat. I won't go to that now. So, strategy battle game lends itself to moments of heroism, and there is a chance that you could get some heroism here. I have called a heroic combat with the Captain. The Castellan of Umbar with him is going to faint. I've got a piercing strike from the Corsair Reaver, and of course we've got a lance there. So these are the dice. The blue ones are the thralls, the orange ones are the captains, the red ones was the Reaver, the red see-through ones. The green one, what's the green one for?
The Castellan.
The Castellan, and the two red ones there for the Morgul Knight. I'll roll this one first because. Okay, so we've got 6s. Oh my days. This could be heroic. Oh! It just. The game just. It lends itself to these things. Unbelievable. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. 50-50 chance. Come on! So it was my priority. Oh, I don't even want to roll this. I'm rolling it with Salt Thrall dice to give it. Mind you, they got high, didn't they?
Yeah.
Oh, let's just see what happens. Oh no! Give me the jig! Woo! So somehow he beats all of them back.
It's all
so
worth it for that.
What does my defense of the Reaver go down to? It goes down by 1 to 3.
Okay, I'll kill him.
So you're going to hit the Reaver? Unbelievable. Well, it isn't unbelievable. So you're hitting the Reaver, so you need 3s. Oh, after all that, it doesn't kill him. But I was pretty banking on that heroic combat, to be honest, to be able to do some other things. Oh dearie me. Oh dear, that was a bit of a gamble.
I can't strike you even.
You can't, well that's alright. Then I'll be running away with him afterwards. Okay, so we're going to the other combats. So we've got the Guard of the Galadrim Court against the Charging Morgul Knight with his lance. Let's see what happens. We get a 4.
We get a 3, but we have got the banner reroll. Whee! And it paid off. That's good. Okay, so he's knocked down. It's that. That's that one. That's the one. Okay, he's knocked down. So we need 4s. Oh yes, and he goes. Next up, we've got the Galadrim Knight, and we've also got the Morgul Knight there. The Morgul Knight did charge. It's 1-on-1 here. You've got a high fight, so you get a 6. You get a 4. We get a 4, but we get a reroll. Come on! We get another 4. That's happened twice. So, I'm guessing you're going for the dude.
Yep,
6s. 6s to kill. Ooh, and it's a 4, so we get pushback. Dolt Thrall versus, I think it's
just one.
It's just one, isn't it? Because he was in that combat before. So you can take him. So what, a Salt Thrall, really? We've got the Salt Thrall versus the Galadrim guy there. Guessing you're fighting as normal. What do you get? You get a 6, so you win that one. So I'm pushed back, and you need 5s to kill him. And you get a 4. That's just not good. You need to be killing these ones, don't you?
Yeah,
next combat, we've got the charging Morgul Knight and the Castellan of Umbar versus the Elf. So, let's see what happens. You get a 5, and we've got the orange dice. What am I doing? The orange dice are the charging Morgul Knight, and the blue dice is the Castellan. And we get that 6. So, we need 4s on the orange dice, and we need 5s on the blue dice. Oh, ouch. And he goes. We've just noticed that this is the last combat of this turn.
Wow.
We've still got one more. But if you don't kill here...
Because Rumal can't strike.
2 turns without killing the model. So we're bringing it up because, of course, that means commentators... it's not going to do me any favours, I don't think. Okay, so the big orange dice is the Castellan, and the blue dice are the Spear Thralls. Salt Thralls, even. We get a 6... Oh, it's off the table. What was it? It was a 3. it's a 5. Good, but not good enough. So, we need 5s off all of the dice. Yeah. And I'm going to say that it was the Thrall who landed the killing blow. And that was the decapitation. So, you've got one more combat left. It's the Dark Marshal versus the Transfixed Rumil. So, next up, we've got the Dark Marshal versus the Transfixed Rumil. Now, Rumil is going to shield, which will take his Transfixed dice to 2. Is that? Or is it the shielding goes on first and then it's...
No, I reckon it'd be the other way around.
Other way around?
So
right, okay.
Just get to it, but yeah, we think that you can shield.
We think that you can shield. Okay, so we're going to see...
Shout the comment.
Yeah, comment below, because we don't know. Okay, so let's see. What does shielding Rumil get? He gets 5 highest. And I can only get a fuck because.
No, you're higher 5. So you only get 5.
Double ones? Does a banner apply to yourself?
Yes.
Oh. So, wow. That's the end of that. Does the game end?
Oh no, he's done it again.
It's off the table. The game continues. Third priority, we reckon that there's probably room in this game for at least one more Tom Heroic here. If he gets priority, maybe try and kill the Dark Marshal. So let's roll for priority. Let's see what we get. He gets a 3. And it's priority, evil. Oh, doom. Do what you just did. Oh! So that's how it looks after my movement. So I just moved in the Morgul Knight there, see how he gets on. We've tried to get quite a bit on in on Rumil even. Surround and trap this guy, more on that Galadrim Knight. So it's on to combats. So the nice simple 1-on-1. You get a 6. You get a 4. What do we get? I get a 4 and I moved Dark Marshal so far away, I don't get the banner rerolls. I can't believe it. Oh, I've only just realised that as I was rolling. Rerolls are always good. Okay, so you need a 6 to kill him. Ooh, scary stuff. So next up is the 3 Salt Thralls and the Castellan of Umbar versus the shielding or fighting. Should we go for it? He's going for it. What does he get? He gets a 4. Can we beat it? Yes, we can. So, needing fives off everything to kill him. Unbelievable. Oh. Unbelievable. He lives.
I don't even put him.
You're putting him. What are you doing? Don't do that. Bring him back. Bring him back. He's a hero. What a lad. What a lad. He lives. Well, that wasn't statistical. So we're going to go on to the next one. This Galadrim with his heroics last time is up against the captain and a charging Morgul knight and two spear thralls. So, salt thralls. I'm getting it wrong now. It's because I get tired. Okay. So let's see what happens. Get a six. We need that six to force the roll off. Whoa, he gets the four. So we're going to start off with the the four dice needing fives from the salt thralls. And they on their own kill him because they're obviously the best troop in the game. Totally broken. Totally broken. So next up, it's Rumil versus a Corsair Reaver who will piercing strike a salt thrall and two Morgul knights. I'll let you roll first because if you get six, double fours. Right, double fours. Let's see what happens. Okay. Morgul knight number one. Morgul knight number two. Oh, I don't like doing this. Corsair Reaver. Salt thrall.
Yes!
You couldn't write this. You just couldn't write this.
Oh, you think you just
couldn't. You couldn't write this. This is just unbelievable. Unbelievable. The salt thrall does it. What is going on? Just. This is unbelievable. Right, okay, so. Rumil, oh dearie me. So the Corsair Reaver goes up to. He's now strength 5. So Rumil was knocked down. So we need 5. We're going to do the Reaver first. We're going to see how many wounds he gets. So needing 5s off the Reaver. Get anything. Oh dear, I don't like rolling small numbers of dice. Okay.
Four is a small number.
Four is a small number of dice. Okay, so we need fours or fives off the
fours.
So let's see if the Morgul Knights kill him. Needing fours, and there are four there. So Rumil is deaded. Should we just see what the Salt Thrall would have got?
Yeah.
He wouldn't have gone on. What are you doing? So, two elves left on the board. Does the game end? Does it end? One or two? And the game continues. The pain is prolonged. So, going into priority, we don't even know what turn it is anymore. So, priority. Well, hey! And it's priority to the elves. Victory! So, courage test for the elves. He sticks around, and we'll do it for the next one. Oh, double ones! And he goes and joins his pals. Oh, dearie me. So, this is how it looks after movement. To be fair, I'm not sure whether I'll do it, which is why I brought the Dark Marshal within 6 inches for the reroll. So yeah, we're going to go into this combat. So, just checking my dice. Is that it? Okay, so we're going to roll these. One of the Castellans is fainting, just so that you know. And we'll see the Morgul Knights are using their lances. So let's see what happens here. So we've got sixes. There's a cock dice. Ooh, and it's a three. Okay, so you can do this. You can do this. If you get a six and win the roll off. No, that was a letdown. I was actually hoping for that drama then. If it had gone with how the rest of this game has gone, then we would have got drama. So our Orc Spearmen, forever known as the Salt Thralls, have definitely been the heroes of this game. So we're going to see if they can do the last kill. So with the 8 dice from them, needing 5s. And they do it. And here endeth the battle. Thank you very much, Mr. Harrison. Great game. Well played. Now, this is a get buff bat rep, so we need to calculate the VPs. So it was 12-10 at one point, but the game has finished 33-10. Now, with the new rule, as suggested by you guys, our first A subscribers, in a get buff bat rep, it is the total number of VPs to the victor
equals.
Sorry?
I didn't vote for that.
You didn't vote for that. Well, they did. So, you're going to get down, and you're going to give me 33. Have you ever had to do this after a game before? I think this should be the new trend for wargamers. Wargamers, get yourself buff with a get buff bat rep.
I think you just concede straight off.
Conceding equals 100 press-ups automatically. Okay, 30, let's have a look. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, keep going. 9, 10, 11, 12, keep going, this is good. 13, 14, 15, remember people are watching, 16, 17, 18, you can do this, 19, 20, 10 more, 10, 9, 8, keep going, come on, 7, 6, come on, 5, 4, 3, now you've actually got 6 more, so go on, give me 6 more, 4, go, 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 6, oh no, so not just broken in game, but broken in body, put your hands up. Well done. Tom Harrison, great sport, great opponent. Had a fab day.
So, Strategy Battle Gamers, this is our post-battle bat rep breakdown. And Tom, you got a little bit of a sweat on there. Had to find the press-ups.
Yeah, it would have been nicer if the game had ended it.
Yeah, a little bit early on. What a game.
Cracking game.
What a game. It was just weird. It was crazy. Some crazy things happened.
Yeah, some great moments. It's a shame it kind of swung away at the end and wasn't close for you guys then.
It did swing, because yeah. At one point it was 10 to 12.
Yeah.
And then those two turns, guys, I think what we need to point out is, you know, if you bring salt thralls to the battlefield, it's just completely broken. Completely broken. There was some crazy rolling.
Yeah. And only one died.
Only one died. See, who needs
seven.
Castellans of Umbar with their defense 6, you know, Corsair Reavers with that piercing strike in 2 attacks, fight 5. Morgul Knights with their lances and the knockdowns and terror. Dark Marshal, who needs that when you've got some orcs with spears? They did really, really, yeah. really well. So, talk us through how you found that battle and how it kind of went.
Yeah, I thought it was obviously a really good game. In terms of what I'd have done differently, maybe, I mean, I don't know, whittled you down a bit more, shooting would have been nice. Didn't manage to kill enough orc spearmen. Could have done with killing them.
Well, at the end, retrospectively, yeah. Seeing how they ended up performing. I mean, we do have to point a couple of things out. You know, this isn't Tom bringing his ultra-competitive force or even playing in an ultra-competitive kind of way. You know, so there were various moments of the game. It's like, I'm not going to move back and do the move back shooting thing because of the camera. Just so that we had a real fun battle report, because we're both playing with armies that we don't usually use.
Yeah, no. And I think, I think I was slightly unlucky in some senses that I just didn't roll to kill when I perhaps needed to, or didn't roll a 6 that I needed to, but that being said, I won the majority of the roll-off, so, you know, it kind of...
You kept saying
out.
It was balancing out.
Yeah.
I mean,
it'd be interesting to watch it back and see how we felt the luck went. Because yeah. Obviously when you're in the middle of the game and you get a few bad rolls, you think, what's happening? But I think probably overall it was probably fair enough.
Yeah, I think that there was just...
Bar the Orc Spearmen.
Yeah, bar the Orc Spearmen. It just destroyed. They're definitely the men of the match, really, because yeah. they kind of swung it. And it was quite a close game for a long time. Mm. And we both felt that it could swing either way, and it came down to priority.
Yeah,
I don't know if you had that feeling. I had that feeling.
Yeah, there was that. Well, there was one turn where I did the two heroic combats and none made it.
That was key. Not killing those guys.
Which lost me 2 might, obviously, and lost me, you know, 4 more guys getting into fights. And then that priority on the turn where it swung was a big one.
Yeah, really good fun. 2 small elite forces sort of really having a good go at each other.
Yeah.
Because it really was like that. And I hope it comes across in the battle report that we have had an absolutely fantastic day. And I'd like to thank Tom on camera because I've taken his whole day. I came down south to pick up Kira Thunderball. You were very, very sporting and said, yep, come to my house, we'll do some games. I was like, yeah, great, we'll take you for lunch. And I've taken up your whole day. what time did I get here? 1:30?
Yeah, about.
And what time is it now?
Late.
Yeah, so I've got a 2-hour trip home now, so I will get off pretty soon. We want to do a couple more things with you.
Yeah.
So I hope you enjoyed that battle report, guys. What did you think, seeing some different armies in action? Did you enjoy it? Did you enjoy, you know, the theme behind the Castamere, the Kinstrife Castamere
poor excuse for a little bit of cheese. I mean, to be fair though, we forgot the rerolls until...
Yeah, it would have been even better if you'd remembered the rerolls and the terror on the Castellan.
If we realised that there was terror on the Castellan, sort of Umbar, and the rerolls, then maybe a little bit.
Oh, top tip for strategy battle gamers, don't give your army list to your opponent before the game, because then they can write a list to destroy you.
That's not what happened.
That's why he brought all the Fight Five.
It's a little bit, I knew he was going to use elves. But to be fair, a big part of it was seeing the Morgul Knights, because I know a lot of you guys have been really, really keen to see what a Morgul Knight is like, and also because I managed to pick up a Dark Marshal blister and some Castellans, and because I've been doing my Reavers as well, I thought, this is perfect. This is a marriage made in heaven.
Yeah.
So it was quite good, and it performed quite well.
Yeah, and then the Orc Spearman struck a genius.
The Orc Spearman was just genius. Genius. The Salt Thralls, the slaves that the Reavers have got on their Reavings. It was absolutely brilliant. No, I really enjoyed that game. Thank you so much for having me. And I hope you guys have enjoyed it too. Did you enjoy seeing the Great British Hobbit League joint leader Tom Harrison in action?
Losing
today. Did you enjoy seeing Tom lose today? Yeah. Did you?
This doesn't mean that James should be top of the league. It doesn't work like that.
No, it doesn't work like that.
As Jamie will back me up on this one.
Jamie will definitely back me. Any opportunity to come up against me, I think. Mind you, I don't think... Has Jamie beaten me yet in a real battle? Has he? I don't think he has. Ooh, that means it's going to happen soon. It's going to be a smashing. This has been another Get Buff Bat Rep. Happy strategy battle gaming.